So, I've already bleached my hair. I've decided I'm just going to show you the process of me getting my rainbow or whatever you want to call it. I got a little extra patch back here that I'm not too sure what I'm going to do with yet. I don't know if I'm going to go fully purple there or do another rainbow. So, first things first. Get the light colors in. So I've got my yellow, my green, my orange. Red. Oh my god, I've already made a blue mark on. Okay. This is how I'm gonna color it. We're gonna go all the way down here. Because that seems more logical. Down there. There we go. How do I get that off? Anything with alcohol in it, you spray it onto it, i.e. a disinfectant or some sort of Febreze, the alcohol in it will eat away at it, so your porcelain will be fine. I see that as it's not coming out. Okay, give me 1 second, I'm gonna pause you. So if that ever happens to you, Lysol disinfectant spray immediately gets color off of any porcelain surface. Wonderful tip if you didn't know. I'm just gonna keep that right there and close the door. So I've also got my black dye for my tips. They are getting a little brown again. I don't like it. So, as I said before, we will be starting with the lightest colors, because we want them to be the brightest, and if there's any cross contamination, it won't really affect it because there's already dye in it. Alright, so here's my yellow, and I'm using punky colors. I've got some hand-mixed colors from before. This is a shocking blue container, but I've mixed a really interesting green in it. You definitely cannot see that color. Oh, okay. I've got more Manic Panic personal mixtures that I've made. Then I have the Manic Panic Red Passion. Got some three bright yellows that I made into a green, an orange, and left bright yellow, which you can see. And then my purple is going to be Manic Panic Purple Haze because Purple Haze just gets the job done every time. And when it fades out, it's kind of nice. So, this is my faded and pre-bleached rainbow. You can tell where my rainbow's going. So I'm gonna swap it on there. Start with my yellow. Put it on that sheet so it doesn't get all crabby. And I'm gonna this section first. Get her out of the way. Should I get the purple in there? Should I just get it in there? Should I? Oh yeah, P.S. I'm not shaving today. Might shave tomorrow. Don't feel like it though. If you're gonna judge, get off my channel. Because we're grown as adults here and we don't appreciate that crap from children or anybody. Because if you do not appreciate yourself, then who the fuck will? Anyways. I'm gonna just get some purple there. Excuse me. Fucking rude. Oh, I see. You're protesting. Alright, see? And then it just drizzles out. And it just oozes. You want it to come out. I know you did. Jesus. It's like my old friend. I don't want to come out. But then when I see that you guys are out, I want to be out. Why don't you just come out for me? and see what happens. Might be fun.
That didn't happen.
Purple under here first. Put my divider sheet down first. And yes, they are Frosty the Snowman Ziploc bags that I've kept. But we don't really need them right now, so figured I can cut it, use it. Again, secure it in there so it doesn't move. I love static cling, it's great. Now I'm gonna get this off. Okay, YouTube, I get it. So should I put it down? This whole section is beautiful. Let's just go right in the dead center. Right dead center. See if I get the yellow one. Then I can dictate where my green is going to go. I can dictate how hot I'm going to put my orange. Make sure I get it off. Put that back for now. Now, the thing that I do with the green, I usually put a teeny tiny little bit on my fingers and then mix it in with the yellow first. I kind of screwed up by using my hand to put a purple out. That's okay. We all make mistakes down here. Dry that off. Don't worry, it's just dyed. And my green turned out really dark, so what I like to do is take just a little bit, my fingers first, and mix it in that previous yellow, and blend it up, so I get like a lime green in there, as well as that nice deep dark green just below that. First I'm going to do it like this. Get my trusty brush again and put some direct dye on there. A straight green. Right on there. Just like that. Now I can actually use my sheet to hold it. Hold it! Hold it! Hold it! I don't know what that was, I'm sorry. P.S. Canadian, I'll say I'm sorry like 15 times or more in this video. Just a forewarning. So now I'm gonna get my secondary green. Should I even put the other green in there? No, I'm gonna go straight to my handmade turquoise. It's kind of like a peacock green. Honestly, I'm gonna squirt it out of my hand again because this color I really like, so I'm just gonna slap a lot of it on. Like a lot of it. Oh, I wish you could see like the vibrancy of this beautiful color. Once I get some pictures taken, I'll put them up somewhere. I'm not sure where. I don't really do the Instagram thing yet. Like, I have one, but I don't. What's the point? Everybody's a fucking freaking bitch on their hands. So I'm gonna get this out. Now, since the next two colors at the bottom are really dark, I'm going to go back up to the orange now. And we're going to put a decent amount of orange in there because, honestly, orange is fabulous and it should get a bigger piece of the pie, we'll call it. Now, for this one, I'm going to use thicker brush, which fits just in the edge of this. I'm gonna scoop some up, just like that. Now we're gonna get all over up here, nice and easy, nice and easy, nice and easy. There we go. As you know, there's nothing worse than looking at your hair and realizing that your favorite color didn't get as big of a shine as it should have. You know what I mean? I've been there. I've done that. Last time I did my hair, it was mostly red up top, and I didn't want barely any red. I wanted like a little sliver of red between the purple and the orange. But I screwed up on that, because the red blended into the orange, and then the purple didn't even take, so the red just bled up to my purple spot, which I did not appreciate. So this time I'm learning my lesson. I'm gonna go in with, put this away. Go in with my purple again. I think I'm gonna squirt onto this actually. There's a piece. Don't you love it? Nope, not saying that. P.S. I have nothing but bad jokes, so until I figure out this YouTube thing, I'm not going to bring any of them up yet, because I don't want to go to jail. I mean, you wouldn't go to jail for jokes, but I mean, like, the ostracization would not be nice to experience on my first YouTube video. Technically not my first YouTube video, because I had an old channel years ago, back when I was still a kid, and I'd upload it almost daily. And then I lost my password, and YouTube doesn't believe me when I say it's me, even though it looks and sounds just like me. Face hasn't changed for years. That's okay. So next one is gonna be our itty bitty red. Now for this, we're not gonna go just straight in with a brush. I'm gonna take the tip. I swear to you, this is what I did last time too. Take the tip. Balance that like that, like an idiot. Now, barely get it in there. Just barely. It's just barely. And I just like that. Now Something about airplanes. Night sky, I think. I don't know. I think there's something about stars, too. I'm gonna do this again to the top. Itty bitty little bit of red. Itty bitty little bit of red. It's okay if it mixes with purple. Because we don't really want the red here anyways. We just want a little hint of it. To say, she's here, but is she really here? We got that in there. I'm going to rinse off our brushes. And get out the blue and the purple. Because the blue and the purple are what I like to call shenanigans. Not shenanigans, shenanigans. Because this blue, once it goes, it goes. Okay, YouTube, I don't want to see Super Bowl reactions, alright? If I wanted to see it, I would have seen it. That was a mistake. Alright, let's get this blue out. And this one's just the straight after midnight blue. It's not too dark. It's enough to say that it's there. She came to the party. I mean, like, she didn't come with a date, but she came to the party. And that's all we could ask. So what I'm gonna do is take something lid. There's like enough on this lid for me. Scoop it up. That's all I need. And then squish her in there. Because we don't want a lot of blue either, you know? The main focal points at this party is the orange, the purple, and that very pretty peacock green that we got going on. Peacock greeny blue. Yeah, I think that's enough blue in there. Level lower so we can mix it to purple. Now, this is the hard part, is the blue stain. We're gonna put our fingers inside the drain, pretty much. To make sure all that runoff goes into the drain and nowhere else. And then, continuity. Again, bad jokes. Didn't work. Still bad joke. Alright. Can I get a little more purple? We're just gonna get her all up in there. Yeah. Get all that purple in there. You know what? I'm wearing a hair dyeing shirt, but I haven't gotten anything on the shirt. What? Shirt's gonna be a freaking rainbow by the time we're done, baby girl. Alright, now we're gonna get our second sheet. Place it on top. Squish them together. And take this purple under the edge here, so it's sandwiched in there. Take that above again. I'm just gonna close these two together. I'm going to take this one like that and put it right back in there. all together. Now they're married. Look at that. Okay. So now we're going to repeat the same process on this one. But this one, we're going to do more sections. Because I have a vertical piece. It used to be just my widow's peak, but I've been extending it over the past couple of years. About 3.5 years ago. About 2.5 years ago, actually, I made just my widow's peak, which was this stark white, like white, but as you can see, breakage. So I incorporated all of this, because I'm fucking psycho, and I love pain, apparently. Alright, now, give ourselves a sheet going backwards to work on. Secure that in there. Should I just bring it to the front? Yeah, I should just bring it. Alright. Section all that out. And that. Actually, I'm gonna use my clips from my hair clippers. Plan ain't broke, don't fix it. Each color in succession. Or should I just slap it all? Yeah, let's be lazy. Let's be lazy. This direction. Put it in like this. On the side. This way, it'll be a straight line. Look at that. Look at that. And that's it. Open her up like a little fan. And just pack her in there. See what I'm saying? Just pack her in there. There we go. Look at that. Beautiful. Alrighty. Let's go the other direction this time. Because we want to make sure this is right. So wipe all that yellow out. Because girl, you've had your moment. You have had your moment and it has passed. Let's get in here with our beautiful orange. Such a bright and happy. greens and yellows have you, but like, realistically, if you get too bright of a yellow, it hurts your eyes. Like, neon yellow hurts my dang eyes. But like, you can't really make neon orange, because the color itself is basically neon as is. See what I'm saying? She was so happy. I don't know, I'm just rambling. I never usually talk when I'm doing my hair, but girl, what are we doing today? We are getting it done too. Let's get some purple in there. I feel like I should be wiping my brush on my shirt. That way I'll get maximum color payoff on my shirt and my hair. Alright. No, not the red first. I did purple. You know what? I'm just gonna put the purple on the brush. Because we are fucking nuts. I see issues arriving. I'm just gonna use my fingers. There we go. Get it in there. Squash it in. That's what she said. But I'm not sure how that would go. Alright. Okay. Tips out. Just to get a little color. A little bit of red never hurt anybody. Unless if it was blood, then it definitely hurt someone. There we go. Oh my god, over here. We're gonna get our green again, fingertip first. I'm gonna slowly slide that upwards to blend it with our yellow. Blend. Now, I'll close this. We'll grab our very, very pretty peacock green. And now, I'm going to have to start separating our colors. think you get the point. I'll come back when I'm starting my black. Okay, so now that I've got the colors in and moved to the side, we're going to start getting this black in there that's already been oxidizing this whole time. I don't know why I was that dumb and let that happen, but I did. I'm going to take a little bit of this, cover up the spots, and by accidentally bleached yesterday. Did my hairline too. Get this over here now. Finish that. Now we're gonna get it in the hotness. Because black is so forgiving, I tend to like to go around little bleached parts. I should probably take out my braid so I can get all of it. But I'll do that off camera if I have the energy. After putting it in my tip. Take it down. Put this up to there so we don't mistakenly get it all black. Clip you in there too. Take out my brain. Spray it in the back. Now this is where we're gonna get messy. Cause it's gonna go everywhere. I hate that I just said that like that. I'm too old to be saying shoot. Too old to be trying to sound you. Alright. Now, I don't think I'm going to go all the way to hairline at the back. And I'm just gonna touch these little parts in the front here. And then separate at the back. Undo that braid. And then we're just gonna go in. We're just gonna get her. And always remember, less is more, so it doesn't slop everywhere. I just barely put my fingertips in. And then I go in. I'm barely in with my fingertips. And then I go in. stopping about an inch to an inch and a half away from my scalp because I don't want to get rid of my gray hairs. I've been growing them out since age 23, and I've got quite a few in the back, but a lot more in my front three parts, like down the center and then my two parts. I have a lot more there that I'm really proud of. I found my first 6-incher the other day. Out there that's in their 20s and just growing out their gray hair, because like the reason why I'm staying away from my head a little bit is because there's quite a bit that are really short, like the hair follicle fell out, and then I noticed that it started coming in gray, so stopped dyeing my hair all the way underneath in those spots, because I figure if I'm gonna go gray, I'm gonna do it from the very first one, because if I can, I'd like to be able to say like, yeah, I started going gray really early, but only in little patches. And I'm gonna respect those patches for who they wanna be. If they wanna be great, they can be great. They wanna be fucking, I don't know. Some of them started coming in gold first. I was like, excuse me? And then the gold started turning to like a whitish gray. It's like, alright, I'm down. But they're really wiry. A little difficult to manage. So I think I'll let them do their thing. Let them be who they want to be. And I'm only going to dye where I know all of my hair is brown. So that's why I'm getting down here. And little bits around my face, this majority of my gray is like in around the center part, the two side parts, and right around the occipital bone at the back of my head. So I leave this patch alone, no dye, and I pull it all to the front after splitting it down the center, and I stop the dye from here up. Definitely on the sides. On the sides, I have no gray, so do a little around here and up here. And I just got black all over my face, and yeah, that's just about it. I think I might rinse these off first, and then I'm gonna put some black in the brows because. Every now and then, after I have black breath. I'm just gonna rinse off this box first. Honestly, I've been using the same pair of gloves for a while. Just they're like the thick, nice ones. So like, if you get a nice pair of gloves, you can just rinse them off. And if you're bougie and you think that's gross, again, you're not welcome here. You can keep your bougie opinions to yourself. Because I guarantee you live in LA and you have nothing to do with me anyways. Sorry, I just think everybody in LA is bougie. I guarantee there's like a handful of people that aren't and that are really nice people, but they're definitely not going to see this video anyways. So I'm just going to wrap them up, put them into another bowl. And this is where the fun starts. Your position makes me go insane. I like to do two little edges first, so I like see if I'm doing it evenly, and then I do my arch. And the straight line from there all the way to the tip of the arch. Oh, oh my God, look at that. No, I don't want to mock that. And then I do my two tails. And straight down. Straight down from the side. Wait. You kind of have like bell eyes, you know, your eyebrows, sorry. It's like they're slightly arched, but at the same time, not at all. Look at my shirt. We got a good color here. It's a nice color story. It's telling me a lot of things. I'm sorry, I will never do that again. What's going on? Garbage. Rinse out these. I'll be right back. I'm just going to rinse out the brushes, clean out my face, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, so, somewhat cleaned myself up. Hands are still a mess. Arms still a mess. Neck is still kind of a mess. Not as bad as it was. Everything here is cleaned up. No stains anywhere. Actually, I should knock on wood. Just in case I find something somewhere. Anyways, these have been on for a couple minutes. I'm going to take them off. See what we get. And, you know what? I'm going to let you guys see first. That's pretty good. Too bad. I could have gone in a little further, but you know, nothing a little bit of pomade can't fix. There we go. P.S. That's just the initial wipe. Now I'm gonna go in some water, fine tune. Off of my skin so it doesn't look like I dyed my skin. Get some more of this off my forehead too, because it's freaking everywhere. And now to the wipe. They look pretty good. Maybe I should give you some light so you can see. There we go. I'm a little red, so don't mind that. you. When I'm done drying it after, well, I'll rinse it out first and then dry it, you know. I'll come back to you when it's all dry and done. How about that? So, it's rinsed out now. I've got a little comb. So you never brush your hair when it's wet, but I'm going to show you guys what's going on in here. So I've got my straight color. You can see all of the colors in there, all the way to the purples. And of course you can't see it. Why did I think you would be able to? You see it in there? The blue to the purple. And my little patch. See what I mean by the red? Like, bleeding into the other colors? And now I got my purple to my red to my orange to my yellow to my green to my blue. And then purple all the way to the end. And again here, same deal. I like that the purple blends in with my hair, because, I mean, the majority of my hair is dark brown. But the ends are now black, so the fact that that purple is, like, close to black, like, as it could get for being purple, is pretty awesome. So, I'm gonna brush out all. I missed a spot. That's okay. We'll cover over that with some purple later. My hair flaky. Upside down. Scrunch, scrunch, scrunch. Flip. Separate. A little more of this. I'm not like squishing it. I'm like this. That's why I need my scrunch. Just gonna scrunch it up to my head. Because I have like really curly hair, but when it's wet, it's like a little heavy. Flip it upside down. Bring you over here. See what I'm doing. Upside down. Squish. 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 And that is that. Couple peekaboo moments. Every time I flip my hair, see like little bits of color. Nothing too much, nothing too little. Just right. Alright, I don't know how to start a YouTube video or how to end it, so we're just gonna. Bye! Actually, no. Bye, eh?